Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to Stylus Syntech channel. If you are new, then please subscribe for more upcoming videos. In this video, we are going to unbox and have a first hands-on of the YuMi Digi A7 Pro in Ocean Blue. And if you're interested in this product, then please support the channel and check out the links below in the video description. So this phone comes in this typical black YuMi Digi box that we also have seen on many of their previous models in the past. The specs are for the price pretty good. It features a 6.3-inch in-cell Full HD Plus screen with a resolution of 2340 by 1080 pixels. It has 4GB RAM plus 64GB storage, but it is also available in a version with 128GB storage. The chipset is the MediaTek Helio P23, and the software is close to stock Android 10 with support for Face ID plus Fingerprint ID. It has a triple tray, where you can use dual nano SIM plus a micro SD slot at the same time. And last but not least, the AI quad camera is on 16 megapixel with ultra wide. In the box we beside the phone and a cover also find a SIM tray pin and an English quick start guide where you can read about all the features, ports, buttons and how to operate it. The charging cable is a USB Type-C in red and black and very standard. And last we have a black CE certified fast charger, where the design is slightly rounded. Here you see the German version. The phone is pretty slim in the hand, still it has a built-in 4150 mAh big battery that can last 1-2 days with normal usage. The fingerprint scanner is located on the rear and easy to access. So let's just take it out of this case. The black case is of rubber and very flexible, with access and cutouts for all ports and buttons. On the back we see info about the camera lenses, buttons and SIM tray. And this color is called Ocean Blue and very beautiful to look at. Depending on the angle and light, the blue color seems to shift slightly and makes it kind of premium to look at. Here a closer look at the quad camera and the fingerprint sensor, which seems solid and good. On the right we have the volume buttons and the power button. The aluminium frame is kind of thick and rounded. In the bottom we find a single speaker, USB Type-C port, microphone and a 3.5mm headphone jack. On the left there is a small hole to open the triple SIM tray. And last in the top we just see two antenna lines. Now let's remove the front plastic to have a better look. As told in the beginning, it has a 6.3-inch in-cell Full HD Plus screen, and in the top we also find a small water drop notch. Let's now boot up the phone for the first time. Here we see the YuMi Digi start animation. After the setup is done, we now see the home screen. The speed of the UI seems okay. It feels fast and snappy. In the bottom we have on-screen buttons and in the top a water drop notch. Let's also test the lowest and highest screen brightness. Overall the screen quality and colors look pretty nice. In the phone settings we can also see that it comes out of the box with Android version 10, so that's great to see. Now let's have a quick look into the camera software. It looks pretty standard and the camera seems quick enough. Here a small indoor sample picture. When zoomed in, the details look fine. But let's also try a picture with bokeh, where the background is slightly blurred. And here some real outdoor shots. It does not really surprise, the quality is not bad but also not super great, but for the price very acceptable. And we can be sure that YuMi Digi will try to optimize the software in the upcoming updates, like we have seen so often on their other models. Next up, let's also test out the rear fingerprint sensor. So here we'll learn a fingerprint via the setup really quick. This seems to work with no kind of problems. And here's a quick test. It is reliable and accurate, but definitely not the fastest I have seen. In the top we also have a 16 megapixel camera hidden inside a water drop notch. The quality is about the same as the rear, meaning that it is more than acceptable for selfies and Facebook. When we use the portrait mode, we get the bokeh effect where the background is blurred. The amount can of course be controlled via a slider. Here at the first look, it is very hard to see if this is software generated or not, but overall it seems to capture the subject pretty good. So that's it for the unboxing and first hands-on. The Yumi DJ-A7 is a very budget-friendly device with a nice design, good specifications and a great camera. The speed, screen quality and overall performance seems good, and for the price you definitely get value for money. Currently we have no long-time experience with this device, but over the few next weeks we will test it more and let you know about pros and cons, and then update the info in the video description. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, drop a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you'll also check out the next one.